Hello students, myself Rekha Vijay from Department of Chemistry of Jaipur Engineering College and Research Center. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic of engineering chemistry, that is glass. In this particular session we will discuss the introduction, properties and the very most important thing, the manufacturing of glass. Now first of all, the introduction. Glass can be defined as a hard, brittle, amorphous, transparent, supercooled liquid with infinite or very high viscosity. It has no sharp melting point, but it is a good electrical insulator. It is a vitrified solid which has no definite composition. It is represented as XM2O YNO6SiO2, where M is the monovalent alkali metal and N is the bivalent alkali metal. Now, these are some important properties of glass. First of all, the physical properties of glass. Glass is a good electrical insulator. It can incorporate coloring material, preserving transparency. They have high compressive strength. They are hard and do not have definite melting point. Now, the chemical properties of glass. Glass is not attacked by air and oxidizing agent. It is alkaline in nature, so water reacts slowly with glass to form NaOH. The reaction with water is enhanced in presence of acids. If acids in glass bottles are kept for long period, then salicylic acid deposit on the glass of bottles. Now, the very most important thing, the manufacturing of glass. For this particular purpose, we required raw materials, silica, sodium carbonate, calcium carbonates, cullates and coloring agent. Now, the process of manufacturing of glass includes five important processes, which includes mixing, melting, shaping, annealing and finishing. This is the diagram of tank furnace in which the melting process will take place at about 1800 degree centigrade temperature. These are some important chemical reactions that occurs during the melting process in tank furnace. In these reactions, the silica will react with Na2CO3 and CaCO3 to form Na2O.CaO.6SiO2, that is soda lime glass, with evolution of entire amount of CO2. Now we will discuss all the manufacturing steps separately. First of all, mixing. In this step, all the raw materials are ground and mixed with cullates and again ground to get finally powdered, and this mixture is called batch. Now the second step is melting, that occurs in tank furnace. Melting of glass is done by heating in tank furnace. The cullate is the broken pieces of glass and it is used to lower the melting point. The tank is heated at about 1800 degree centigrade temperature. The materials melt and fused with hot gases. On continuous heating, the entire amount of CO2 will escape and viscous fused mass is obtained. It is known as plane. Heating is now stopped and now it is allowed to cool. The next step is shaping. The molten glass is shaped into desired shape by either blowing or molding. Then the next step is annealing, which is the very most important step during the manufacturing of glass. The glass articles are allowed to cool gradually at room temperature by passing through a series of different chambers with descending temperature. This is known as annealing. Glass is a bad conductor of heat, so the rapid cooling makes only outer surface cool as compared to inner surface, and this situation may cause for stress and strain. Therefore, to avoid such problem, glass should be cooled very slowly. This slow cooling process is termed as annealing. Now, this is the next and last step, that is finishing. After annealing process, all type of glass require finishing. It is done by cleaning, washing, polishing, etc.